In this edition of Art Loft, Gallery of Amazing Things.
We have Eostone, which is a natural history company. We have Seaway China Company, which is a ceramics company.
Thunder and Enlightening.
The theme of the project is freedom and hope. And we've given Mr. Parker total creative license to create what he thought would represent that for the community.
Beneath the Surface.
It's a collection that we started about close to 30 years ago. We always felt it had to be open to the public.
And
they use animals to discuss everyday family and friendship issues, and it makes it easier to talk about.
It's all ahead on this edition of Art Loft.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation and
in the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.
This project is sponsored in part by the Department of State, Division of Cultural Affairs, the Florida Council of Arts and Culture, and the State of Florida.
Hi, I'm Kaylin James, and from the Cornell Art Museum at Old School Square in Delray Beach, this is Art Loft. Welcome to another edition of Art Loft. First up, we head down to Dania Beach to visit a gallery whose name is no exaggeration. The Gallery of Amazing Things is home to so many elements, it's best if we just jump right in. Join us as founder Aaron Rimpley gives us a tour of this astounding venue.
The Gallery of Amazing Things is the name of the facility, and within the Gallery of Amazing Things, we have different events, weddings, product launches, museum events, and then within the Gallery of Amazing Things, we have sub-galleries. So we have Eostone, which is a natural history company. We have Seaway China Company, which is a ceramics company. House of Whitley, which is a luxury gallery that also sells fine art. And the W Moda, which is the museum that's located on the second floor. We take you through the Eocene period, which is the first gallery as you come in on the right, and that takes you through all of the big stone, the big rocks, and some incredible things. As you wander through the exhibition on the first floor, you'll see other things. We have a 30,000-year-old fossilized horse. We have several rare species of more three-dimensional objects. As you go through, you find the Christopher Marley exhibit, which are all the taxidermy pieces. Those exist throughout the rest of the gallery. What's really wonderful about Christopher Marley, we do have some things that you'll see in the gallery. For instance, we have a large black snake that's framed out in one of the gallery walls. We also have birds that were in part of a series where you see the expansion of the wings. Nothing that Christopher uses is killed. It's a process called reclamation. So these sanctuaries and things where these animals are living, when they pass, they're frozen and they're kept for Christopher to use in his designs. And currently in the room that I'm sitting in now, this is our crystal room, and we wanted to create an effect in here to draw your eye in to the crystals. That's why the room's set a little bit darker than the rest of the galleries. And when we're not filming, there are sounds that play in this room that are binaural sounds that activate the same brainwave patterns that you have when you're meditating. So when you sit in here with binaural sounds playing, with the lighting right, and you sit on the bench, you have this amazing feeling, this feeling of peace and tranquility in the room. And it's just a beautiful space. I've been dying to create a crystal room for many years. I've had it in my mind, and this was done in a very deliberate way. in one of the galleries on the first floor, we did a Yadro concept gallery. Yadro is a company that's been around for quite some time. They're everything from Yadro is made in Spain. And we created a gallery for the company, a different type of gallery than you'd see in a typical store, with some of their very unusual pieces. And one of those pieces includes a chandelier that we have in the lobby of the building. And that chandelier is 300 individual fairies, butterflies, that are beautiful, that I'm sure you'll see in the video. And that is one of three that are in the United States. There's one in Beverly Hills at their store in Beverly Hills. There's one in New York City. And then we are very proud to have this one here in South Florida. My original career is in ceramics. I'm a ceramics and porcelain pottery specialist. That's how I started my career at 23. And I worked in that industry, in that world for many years. I still do. There's a lot of interest in ceramics and glass. It is an overwhelming topic because there's so many pieces that have been made, you know, especially the collection that we have put together. The collection starts from the 1700s and it takes place all across the UK and Spain. So the collection encompasses a lot of time and a lot of different types of materials. And so my focus was to create an experience for a person who may not be very familiar with all the different brands and the different types of things and the different artists that have been around since the 1700s. And we wanted to create a feel of relaxation, pace, and beauty, and tell a story in a very simple way without overwhelming the visitors to the museum. So as you're walking through upstairs, you get a feel. We set things by color, style, and type. And so it kind of leads you through this journey through this from the 1700s forward to modern production. And so you get a great feel for the different artistry and the different things that were going on in the world at the time when these pieces were made. And again, it's done in a very deliberate way. It's very measured and designed not to be overwhelming. From the very first day that we were here, that in order for the gallery to work, there would have to be numerous things happening at once, that we would have to have a place where people that had creative ideas and wanted to try something, that they would have a place to be able to do that and to be able to do it in a way that is affordable for them and really to try something and to try a concept. So we've been very fortunate that we work with some brilliant people that have brought us wonderful events and wonderful opportunities. We've had incredible musical acts, we've had beautiful live poetry readings, we've had amazing artists and performance artists and all sorts of things that are really inspirational. And it's not just for people that have a lot of money. We have students and we've done things for many, many charities. And so it's a great way for us to be able to give back and for other people to have these experiences here in the gallery.
I told you it was amazing. For more on the Gallery of Amazing Things, visit galleryamazing.com. Art lovers, we want to see what you find amazing. Tag at ArtLoftSFL on your local arts photos on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Up next on Art Loft.
It's a collection that we started about close to 30 years ago. We always felt it had to be open to the public.
In Miami-Dade's Liberty City, we attend the unveiling of the One United Bank mural project. For the four-month project, artist Adonis Parker mentored 21 students in the planning and production of this socially conscious and culturally significant piece.
As we decided to do this mural project, we really were looking for an artist that was going to be authentic in their creation. The theme of the project is freedom and hope. And we've given Mr. Parker total creative license to create what he thought would represent that for the community. He's been working with some students, some apprentices, who have surveyed the community and talked about some of the needs and feelings in the community, and he has incorporated that into his art.
Project is, we took five from five different high schools. We have 21 kids. We're teaching them the apprentice about how to do what I do for a living. They're kind of like the internal, they're more intimate you know, details about how to be a fine artist, also slash commercial artist, and how to survive in this industry.
My part from a mural itself is designing my own, because everyone has their own separate designs and one will be picked and we'll all contribute to it. And basically my role is to think of a personal original design.
I want people to have an understanding, have an open mind when they view the mural. This mural came from the depths of my heart. It came also, I've been holding this idea for a very, very long time. I've got plenty commissions, plenty murals, all that, pictures, paintings and all that, but this is the first time in my life that I actually had a chance to paint what I want to paint and express myself artistically. This will be a testament of Adonis Parker, yeah. And this will not be the last, but this will be the beginning of great things. And the name of the mural is Thunder and Enlightening. And I'm quite sure that you will, just like you can see thunder and feel it, you will see the enlightening like lightning.
For more on Parker, including additional works and art courses, visit art-forever-studios.org. And for more on the Liberty City Renaissance series, visit miamichildrensinitiative.org. Up next on Art Loft.
They use animals to discuss everyday family and friendship issues, and it makes it easier to talk about.
At De La Cruz Collection Contemporary Art Space in Miami, we visit the exhibition Beneath the Surface. This exhibition engages the works of over 24 artists to illustrate the effects of globalization with processes that include figurative painting, new abstraction, and more.
It's a collection that we started about close to 30 years ago. We always felt it had to be open to the public, so we would open our own home to anybody interested in seeing the artworks. At first, we didn't realize that a collection is really not just buying works for behind your sofa. It's much more than that. And we start building, like you're putting works in a home, in a house. But with time, the house became too small for the artworks. That's when we decided to build this space. The way we've installed the collection is sort of a bit of a surprise. Even though you've read before what the De La Cruz collection is showing this year, when you enter the room, it hits you. It is a surprise. You walk in and you see Sterling Ruby's work, and you see this huge stalagmite, which really started to being like a stalactite that he made pouring resin until it hardened. And now it looks like a tower, and it really, it's not a tower. It was the artist pouring resin like a stalagmite and then turning it around and making it, you know, putting it on the floor. Then his paintings, he uses the technique of graffiti art. Of course, graffiti art is, I would say, is something that we're all familiar with. And many of the artists today have the technique of graffiti art, which is instead of using a brush, or using, you know, what you usually use for a painting, they use a spray can. And one of the artists is Sterling Ruby, which we see this beautiful works at the entrance, totally abstractions. And the abstractions, when you see the paint, you say, oh my God, how did he put the paint? How is the paint so, I mean, it looks so perfect. And really it's because he's using the spray can. You keep walking and you see weight guidance works, which are massive because they're 18 feet high. And actually what he did was he used the inkjet press, but then the rest of the canvas, only about 3 feet have the printing part, and the rest is a white canvas, and you can see the stains of him pulling the canvas from the inkjet press, how the track marks are there. And it's funny that in front of him is the light piece of Felix González Torres, who was an artist who unfortunately died very young. And he was one of the most important conceptual artists, really well-known conceptual artists. And Wade, which is a post-conceptual artist, asked if we could install the light piece in front of his work because he wanted to have Felix's work. And the director of the space, Yvette, told Wade, remember that every time they take a picture of your painting, they're going to see those lights hanging. And he said, that's exactly what I want. I want to be with the work of Gonzalez Torres. So you see how also artists like to build relationships and how they like to, I mean, I always ask the artists when we're installing, where would you like to be installed? Because I think the work really doesn't belong to me, it belongs to the artists. And I want to know what, I want them to feel comfortable here in my space, in our space. I don't want them to feel that we're just showing them for some kind of narcissist. No, the artwork belongs to the artist and the artwork continues to be part of the artist's work. So it's important to get their input and try to, as much as possible, develop a relationship with the artist. You go to the third floor and you see all these faces of portraits by Rob Pruitt. There are 250 faces. And of course, you go in there and then you see in the work, the candy piece of Gonzalez Torres, so you see the conceptual artist introduced in this room full of portraits. And of course, you don't expect to see 250 portraits on the wall. And then you go into the Mendieta room and again, you see an artist who's a descendant of she was a performance artist and her work is all about the woman's body. No doubt a relationship, she has a relationship with Frida Kahlo, but from the Kahlo also being, you know, the relation of the strength of the woman body that can create. So you walk in there and you don't expect to find Mendieta, who's an artist from the 70s. And then you go to the second floor and the same thing, there's a platform in the second floor where all the sculptures are installed. Where we have, not all the sculptures, but the sculptures we decided to install, Pernice, Isa Genskin, and Arturo Herrera. I mean, there's so many works installed. That's another thing. People say, oh my God, what a great idea to put the sculptures in this huge platform, because then people can really relate to the sculpture and they can walk and see them all. We also have a program where we have classes for students here in Miami, and we also have a travel program and a scholarship program. So we care a lot about the community, and the space is really open to our community.
For more on the De La Cruz Collection Contemporary Art Space, visit delacruzcollection.org. Next week on Art Loft.
Fairchild started its art program in 2005, and our very first art exhibit was Dale Chihuly. And it seemed very appropriate to celebrate our 10th anniversary by bringing Dale Chihuly back to Fairchild. And what makes his medium, which is glass, so wonderful within a garden setting is that it's very malleable. It's very soft.
Stageworks Theatre is a 31-year-old theater company here in Tampa Bay. It was founded by Anna Brennan, who is a director and an artist who still lives in the area. Stageworks has basically two arms. We have the producing arm, which is the plays that we do, and then we have the educational arm, which goes out into the community and teaches, brings art to people who won't necessarily have access to it otherwise. We have a very exciting future. You know, we're here in the heart of the Channel District, which is where a lot of good things are happening now, development, building new buildings, and downtown, which has been revitalized over the last several years, too. So it feels like we're in the right place at the right time, and we look forward to a very, very bright future.
Oh, I ask every bird who comes back from the outside to tell me what it's like, and they talk of things called trees that extend up, up, up a steel. Opening onto an everywhere blue. with something called clouds, moon, and wind.
Birds of a Feather tells the story of two different groups of animals. There's a set of penguins, two male penguins in the Central Park Zoo, who adopt a chick and raise it as their own. And there's also a set of hawks who live at the top of a building in Manhattan that houses the rich and famous. Mary Tyler Moore lived there. Paula Zahn and her husband, a real estate developer, lived there. So those two stories were going on in New York at the same time. And Mark Aceto, who was a reporter for NPR at the time, covered the story, I want to say, for NPR. And then he thought it was an interesting way to talk about families. And so he built this play.
20 years ago, you came into this marriage with a net worth of exactly $250,000. And I busted my hump, turning it to $25 million. So all you had to worry about was your precious job.
And raising your children.
This story is a story about relationships, so it follows two main relationships in the story, but it has a bunch of smaller relationships that are throughout the story as well. And so it's really cool to see the parallels of all the relationships throughout this throughout the story.
They use animals to discuss everyday family and friendship issues, and it makes it easier to talk about.
Is all about find the food, find the mate, make the nest, make the chicks, protect the nest, find the food, over and over again
until it's over.
Exactly.
No, Taylor, I mean it's over.
So it's a way to look at parenting and how we look at families and how we define them and what makes yours different from mine but not necessarily better than mine. So it's a lovely play that talks about, you know, unity and how we can all work and live together.
But Chastity has never engaged in any controversy until she encountered this book. Chastity, why do you object so strongly to this book?
Well, Diane, I feel...
Paula.
Aren't you Diane Sawyer?
I'm Paula Zahn from CNN.
I've known Carla Hartley, the director, for a while, and I've auditioned for her a bunch of times. And she asked me if I wanted to be a part of this, and I was like, absolutely. Penguins, a zookeeper, gay bar, absolutely.
Everything.
It's a great show that I'm proud to put on, mm-hmm. and, you know, to discuss the different relationships and understand people as human beings, really.
It was fun. It was quirky. It fits right into Stageworks' mission, which is at its base about diversity and how do we develop lines of communications from one group of people to the next.
It was a very neat show.
Yeah, and love runs through it all. You know, it's there, and so you don't want to block that off. Yeah.
We need to be more inclusive of families that love each other. Love is really the only thing that matters. So it's a special play for that reason.
I taught him in Manhattan for 3 years. We had a section in our library that was books that were banned, and this book was featured. So it's a very real thing, and that's what the show opened with and closed with, is that everything in the story is true, except for the fact that birds can't talk.
The arts affect every aspect of a community, and I think not enough people know that or are willing to hear it. But that's our mission, is to bring arts to the communities that can't necessarily come here, but also we want people to come here to experience it. And, you know, we have a long history of diversity and bringing different groups of people together, and that's really one of the greater focuses of the organization is to teach diversity, to teach harmony. And it sounds sort of pie in the sky, and it sounds idyllic, and that's exactly how I want it to sound.
Thanks for joining us this week. Let Art Loft inspire your creativity every day. Visit WPBT2.org/ArtLoft to watch past episodes. And get social with us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram at ArtLoftSFL. I'm Kaylin James, reminding you to stay creative. Bye. What did we say before? Venue. And I'm gonna do this instead. No, it's not. Well, you can give it a turtle. Just quiet back there. What the hell are you doing, Jeffrey? Do you see what I'm saying? I feel like it should be, like, I would, if I told you, I'd go, would you please tag at Kaylin James on this photo? That's the way I would say it to you if I was asking you, like, please tag me on your photo. I wouldn't say, tag your photo at me. Love it, and I nailed it. One more, or are you good? Cameraman with attitude. I felt like I had like a sore throat before the race, but then I ran so long and then it went away. So I thought maybe I just flushed out all the toxins. Almost there, guys. If Serena will just get it right, we'll be out of here.
Funding for Art Loft was made possible by the John S. and James L. Knight Foundation and...
In the Florida Keys and Key West, every night is a spectacular show. And every day is another masterpiece.
This project is sponsored in part by the Department of State, Division of Cultural Affairs, the Florida Council of Arts and Culture, and the State of Florida.